everyone. Hope you're having a good afternoon. So yeah, thanks for the introduction, Gavin. So SpotX, for those of you who don't know, are a modern video ad serving platform. So my role within the business is to run the demand team, so a fancy name for a sales team. So I get to sell all of the great publishers who use SpotX's technology to monetize their video inventory. So today we're going to talk about, as Gavin said, something that we probably all have in our houses, but perhaps haven't really thought in a great deal about what that connected television on the wall is, and the mechanism by which ads are delivered into those ad opportunities. So mentioned it already, we purely focus in video ad serving. So we've been around since 2010. We're cross-device, but what we're doing now is developing our ad-serving technology to really maximise the value that we can bring from connected devices. We have connections with a huge number of DSPs, so this has been in our DNA video purely from the very beginning, 2010. So a bit of context, I'll mention in a moment, just talk to you about some more acronyms in our advertising landscape, which is always interesting. Benefits for the advertiser, ad experience, and then some research that we commissioned for the European market. So follow your internal consumer. Tech is changing all the time. So what we have to do is understand where those consumers are heading. What you might see in the trade press and newspapers is just this idea that television is dying. So is that a fact, or is it just that things are changing? People are cutting the cord, people are shaving. So who in this room in the last, let's say, 5 years has actually changed their Sky TV or cable package? Maybe they've shrunk it down. So you're a cord shaver, apparently. Okay, so you're just trying to get a handle on your monthly expenses when it comes to consuming content on TV. Cord cutters. So I'm a cord cutter, I have been for 5 years. And what this means is that I no longer have Sky TV or Virgin Media, just have broadband. And then you've got cord nevers. So who in this room has ever actually purchased Sky TV or a cable package? So there we go, we've got a couple of people. So how are you going to advertise to these people if they're not actually consuming media in a traditional way or via subscription services? So with all that being said, it would seem that there's a lot of things changing. 55 million people in the US alone this year cut the cord or are actually not using, not accessing content in that way. However, television itself, viewing consumption is standard at 3 hours all over the world. So the only two places where people watch less than 2 hours a day is Iceland, although with the World Cup coming up, I'm sure that's going to increase, and Myanmar. And I've not been there. I know it used to be called Burma. So anybody who's been there, perhaps you will know more than me about why that is. So anyway, TV is still really, really important. And then in the UK, Barb tells us that although disruption is happening, TV viewing, so viewing on a television, usually in your living room, is still very much resilient. And what you're seeing is just consumers changing their behavior. So just going back a little bit, when I was a young lad, a long time ago now, we would have TV in the room and you'd all sit around and watch your favorite program. And obviously advertisers could reach you in that way. But you would basically be watching scheduled TV programming. I then remember going to my best friend's house, and his dad was a businessman, and he was the first kid in the school to have Sky TV, so we'd watch MTV together, but you were still restricted to watching scheduled TV programming. Then as technology improved, what you were able to do was essentially pause TV, choose a time to watch it, so you could actually maybe catch up on a TV show a day, a week, or even an hour later. So within that, you then got more choice and more flexibility of watching. And then fast forward to today, you can plug the internet into a TV or connected device, and you have even more choice. So it's kind of gone exponentially crazy. Just lots and lots of information, lots of choice for the consumer. So as advertisers, you've got to follow these guys. So I'm going to concentrate on the bottom two rectangles on the right there, the internet and smart TV. So what is OTT? And really, it's a definition of how content, broadcast content, is delivered over the public internet as opposed to private networks used by cable or satellite providers. So it's worth thinking about that. So OTT is broadcast content usually delivered into connected devices, whether that's mobile phone, tablet, or desktop. And then you have this other thing that's just been around for a number of years now, and I'm sure we all have them. In fact, who does have a connected TV in their room? Is it majority? So 75%, 80% of people. And what that is it TV that can be connected to the internet, or devices that use that TV screen, essentially as the access point for that. And then you're accessing content. So in my house, I have a smart TV. It's a JVC. I'm not really sure why I bought a JVC, because it doesn't connect with too many things, but it does have a Netflix button on the handset. Okay, and then I've got Apple TV. I was never into gaming consoles, I don't know why, but nevertheless, I've got a selection of ways to access content within my own house. Okay, but the key thing here is it's big screen. So this is a perfect advertising medium. So this is what advertisers want. And usually, I'm sat there with my wife, my baby, my dog. One's making a noise, one's barking, and we're all there together. So the value of that advertising moment can actually be very, very valuable. It is different. It usually plays long-form content. It is broadcast quality. But then we have a couple of, not necessarily restrictions, but things that advertisers must bear in mind. So cookieless environment and vast format. Ad experience. I didn't set any live examples up just in case there are a few snafus, but ad experience, it's full screen, it's soulless, you have pre-roll or mid-roll, so it's really, really interesting for an advertiser. You do have interactive opportunities. Again, it's relatively nascent, so you're bringing interactivity, which is obviously very, very familiar on desktop devices in particular, and certainly mobiles, into a TV. So perhaps until these, and we've all got those annoying controls lying around the house that are kind of a little bit clunky and not quite so easy to use. So until they're better, perhaps the previous slide is the best option. So in terms of performance, this is why it's a real no-brainer for advertisers. 97% completion rates, and that's versus the industry standard for online video of around 79%. We can offer targeting, and obviously we can offer measurement. And this idea that one ad shown is actually equivalent to 1.6 people viewing it. So some really hard-hitting numbers there for advertisers. And then in the UK, we are seeing a huge increase in the uptake of these smart TVs and connected devices. So a big increase on these slides in front of you is driven by Now TV, which is Sky's move from being a pure satellite cable provider into also offering streaming services. So even the broadcasters ahead of the game, thinking about how consumers are changing and how they can obviously follow consumer behavior. So then, I've mentioned it already, cord shavers and cord nevers. And these are the people that you're potentially missing out on if you don't consider a connected TV campaign. So winners and losers, mentioned it already. So virtual MVPDs. This is kind of what Sky are doing with Now TV. They're just changing their business model while keeping the traditional business model going. And you know, they will work with that as it goes on. But certainly cable and satellite viewers, these are US figures. They're feeling the pinch, but again, they are also developing their own businesses to change with the consumer. So in the UK right now, 65% of households have a connected device. I think that's probably increased. These are probably 6 months old, this data. And yeah, I've mentioned it already, the most popular or most recognisable name is probably Netflix. So with Netflix, it's a subscription VOD service. So it might lead you to think that actually SVOD will be the primary business model. But analysts do think that advertising VOD is going to explode. And reasoning behind that is, so I've already mentioned I have Apple TV, I have Netflix, that's two subscription services. Am I really going to go for another two or three or four to find content? And I've thought about it, and I haven't done that yet because of the JVC TV, but also I'm hoping that there'll be some ad-funded content, or services rather, that I can access. It means I don't then pay a subscription, but obviously you have the trade-off. So there you go. So it's for all of these reasons mentioned that what we're seeing is just a change in the behaviour of where people are watching TV. Okay, so linear consumption is perhaps falling, but it's being driven into OTT areas and advertisers can reach them. So we also conducted a market sizing survey. So this was with MTM, so a European-wide research group. And it was really looking to establish the scale or the scope of the OTT connected TV market in EMEA. So we conducted roundtable panels in Germany, France, Spain, Italy, and in London. These were our partners who we invited. So it's obviously technology partners, agencies, broadcasters, everybody within the ad tech and broadcasting space. And the reason we invited them for a panel to establish the research is when there's not so much information on a nascent business, using this method gives you some really robust information that you can take to market. So I'd happily share all the information with you after this. The research was looking at kind of clearly obvious things. So does a market have high broadband penetration? Because you do need that to deliver high quality broadcast video onto TVs in particular. Audience viewing. So is London atypical? Does Italy and Spain, do they have the number of connected devices that we have in the UK? The answer is not yet, but it's growing. Advertiser demand, so are advertisers willing to try this new stream? But equally, are broadcasters set up to monetize? Are they willing to test? Are they willing to just try a different revenue opportunity? And then barriers, things like outdated regulation in certain European countries, and how long will it take for those to change? So the good news is, and no surprise, the market is very, very big. Certainly the UK is leading the way. However, as you can see here, we're looking at France growing very significantly in 2 years, but also Italy, who actually had a couple of restrictions in terms of regulation and broadband and whatever else. They're actually very, very bullish about these new advertising opportunities. So yeah, that's it. CTV is and OTT itself are really fantastic opportunities for advertising, and to marketers or marketeers, I'm not sure which one's correct. Yeah, we can help facilitate those connections, and yeah, the opportunity is there. Thank you.